Hello, hi friends. My name is Nilesh. If this is the first time you are visiting this channel, please feel free to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button if you find this video useful, and also share it with your friends and family. So in this video, we are going to talk about how to use the aliases. In the earlier two videos which I did on the Kubernetes exam preparation for Certified Kubernetes Administrator and Application Developer, CKA and CKAD, I mentioned about the time management techniques, and one of the things I highlighted in those time management techniques was to create a set of aliases. Now the aliases are like shortcuts, and this can be a huge time saver. In both the exams that I attempted, I found it very useful to create my own aliases while working with the Kubernetes environments. And today I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's switch to the terminal. Here I'm using Windows terminal, which is my favorite terminal, and I'm logged on to the one of the nodes of my Kubernetes cluster. So when you appear for the exam, you will also have an environment, and through the browser, you can connect to the different clusters that are provided as part of these Kubernetes exams. So the first thing that we can do is we can store these aliases in some of the file, like any favorite editor that you have, like Notepad or Notepad++. And before the exam starts, we can create these aliases and we can copy them. This is again to save the time. And before your exam, before you start the exam in your browser, you can copy this and keep it in your clipboard. So this is what I'm going to do here. And then you can close this. So let's close Notepad++. Now we have all the aliases stored in our clipboard. And once the proctor gives you a go ahead to start the exam, first thing you can do is open the Notepad feature of the Kubernetes test environment and paste these aliases there. Now the way aliases works is it creates a shortcut within your session. So I can create an alias here for this particular session that I'm working with in my Linux environment. So let's say I want to create an alias called CLS, and I want to use this as a shortcut for the clear command. Now, anytime I type CLS, it will give me a clear screen. This will work only for this current session. But if you want to persist this across sessions, you can use the profile, which is like your user-specific profile created in your target environment or on your Linux machine. We can search for this by using the locate command. And the name of the profile is, since we're working with bash terminal, it is bashrc. And we can see here that there are multiple bashrc or dot bashrc files. The one which we are interested is in this home user or az user and dot bash profile, because that is what is my current user that I'm logged in with. So my current directory or the current user is as a user, and the home directory for that is /home. So I can open this, the bash profile or profile file, which is bashrc, using an editor such as vi editor or vim editor. And again, to work with vim, in my exam tips, I had shared this PDF file, a vim cheat sheet. So if you're coming from a Windows background like ARM, you might not be familiar with the vim commands or vi commands. You can go through this and you can understand how the different VI commands work. If you want to copy and paste, and if you want to copy multiple lines, or if you want to delete multiple lines, these commands will be really helpful for you. So coming back to the VI editor, here we can see that there are already some basic commands, or the profile is already set with some of the settings. And we can see that there are some existing aliases here already, like the LL for LS and -ALF, LA and L. Now in this, I'm going to add my new aliases. So whatever we have copied in the clipboard, we can paste it here. So I created an alias for CLS earlier, and then I want to alias kget. K is already aliased in your environment, but test environment, I mean. In case it is not, or just to be safe, you can also alias K, and you can say K is for kubectl. If it is multiple commands, then we will have to put it inside single quotes or double quotes. If it is just one command like clear or kubectl, then we don't have to put it inside the quotes. So here I want to create shortcut for kubectl get, which is, since my k is already alias or kubectl is alias test k, I can reuse that alias for the subsequent commands. So I'm using kget as kg. I'm aliasing kget pods as kgpo. And here also you can see that I'm using the short form of the pods and the nodes. So for the nodes, I'm going to use kgno as the alias. Kapply files, since we are going to use a lot of manifest files in the exam, we can also create a shortcut for applying and deleting. And then we will be also describing a lot of objects in the exam. So these are the commonly used commands which I want to alias so that my time can be better utilized while I'm answering the Kubernetes exams like CKA, CKAD or CKS or even the new CKNA exam. Along with this, I'm also creating two shortcuts or two exports. I can't create these as alias because they have a different flag or they use different flags here, and we will be using them as part of the other commands. So I create a export for dry run as client and output as YAML. This is again quite frequently used when we work with this exam or when we attempt these exams to persist the output of a particular object like a deployment or pod into a YAML format. And before we create the object using imperative command, we can dry run that and we can store it in the YAML file. So I'll show you a quick example of this. And we also create an export for the force and graceful deletion of the pods. So when we, not just the pods, graceful deletion of some object. So when we delete some object like pod, for example, there is a short amount of time it takes to delete. And if you don't want to wait for that time, we can force the pod to be forcefully deleted so that it gets deleted immediately. And we set the grace period at zero. So these are the two exports I have set. And with this, I can store this using the WQ and exclamation mark. The changes are stored. Now our bash profile is updated with the aliases and those two exports. To use those aliases in our session, we have to refresh our environment. So let me first clear this screen. Now this particular terminal session or bash session has to take those changes into effect. So we do that by using the source command and giving the path of the file which we want to source. So this will be .bashrc. Now all those aliases that we created as part of our bashrc or bash profile are available to this terminal session. So let's say if I type cls, the clear command works. If I want to list down all the pods, I can run kgpo, and I can use these aliases in combination to the flags which the kubectl provides. So I can use, let's say, kgpo kget pods with the namespace, and in my cluster there is this set of default namespaces. So let's try kubesystem, for example. So you can see that it filters the pods within the kubesystem namespace. Then let's clear the screen and we can try kget, and I want to get all the namespaces, so I can use kgns. Now, if I want to list all the elements of or all the objects, all the pods, let's say within other namespace, I can say kgpo namespace as other. And currently there are no resources in this namespace, but we can see that it's very easy to use these aliases. I'll show you the example of those flags which we created or exported. How do we use that to, again, improve our efficiency while working or while answering these Kubernetes exams? So there could be a question which says you have to create an object within, let's say, this other namespace using the image, which is nginx, and the tag as table. So we can use the imperative command krun, and we can give the name for this as nginx. And the image that we want to use here is it could be image equals or image then space. We can give nginx and the tag as stable. And the namespace that we want to use here is other. Now, before I run this command, I want to store this as a YAML file. That could be another requirement. So this is where I can use the dollar sign and I can use that dry run and the output as YAML file. And I can give the name of the file here as nginx-pod.yaml. So here we can see that it created a YAML file using that imperative command, and it gave us the manifest for creating a pod. Let me just clear this and rerun this command, which is creating that YAML file and storing it as a manifest, or showing the manifest in the dry run. It's not creating the object yet. Now I want to redirect this to a file called, let's say, nginx pod. So this could be for question number 5, for example. So I can say 5 nginx pod.yaml. Now in this case, what would happen is it would create a file with that output. So if I look at this file nginx pod.yaml, and then we can use the vi command here, by nginx pod.yaml, to see what was the output that was generated as part of that imperative command. So we had the manifest created with the kind as pod, the namespace as others, the image as nginx, and let's say our question was to create the image with the name as nginx as other. Nginx-other was the name of the image. So with that, we can save these changes. And now to apply this file, I can use that alias again, kapply file, and I can give the name as 5 nginx pod yaml. This object is created. I can run the kgpo command with the namespace as other, and I will get this nginx pod created there, or the status of that particular pod in the output. Now if I want to delete, this is where I will use the other export. So for that, let's clear the screen. And what I want to do is I want to delete the nginx. Let's first get the pod name. Let me run that command again. It's named as nginx. So I want to delete this nginx pod. So delete nginx as the pod, or delete pod nginx. The namespace is other, and I don't do wait for the time. So let's try this first to see how much time it takes. Here it's get deleted fast, but in some cases you might see that it's taking time to delete. So let's first create it again and then go ahead and delete it using the export that we created. So now I want to run this delete command, but I want to run it with the force output, or with force and without using the grace period, or with using grace period as 0. So it should immediately delete. So you can see that it throws up a warning here saying immediate deletion, does not wait for the confirmation of the running resources, and it will forcefully go and delete the nginx pod. So this way, what we saw in this video was how to create aliases, how to create them before starting the test, how to update your bashrc file, then use those aliases using the source command, and then how to use the two export commands, or how to use those two utilities so that you can quickly create objects using imperative kubectl commands and store them as YAML manifest files. Apply those, and finally how to use this deletion of the objects again using an export with immediate effect. So using this force as the flag and also the grace period as 0. So I hope that using this, what I've shown here is just about 5 or 6 different aliases, but depending on what your comfort level is, or how many aliases you want to create, you can create those aliases which you will be frequently using during your test, so that it makes easier for you to work with these objects during the test. It can save you a lot of time instead of typing all the full commands like kubectl, get, pods, hyphen namespace, or hyphen hyphen namespace, and so on and so forth. So I hope you found this useful. Please, if you find this useful, then go ahead, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and please share it with your friends. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.